You've seen us with the Falcon. We haven't done much other than drive it to work and back every day, basically just trying to work the bugs out of it. I've been driving it myself just to make everything sweet, especially because my job's quite a further distance than Allison's. So basically I found that the gearbox has started hunting again. I've talked to Dean the tuner, and yeah, we've come to the conclusion that some of the mechatronics unit must be stuffed again. It was only a second-hand unit that we did put in this initially anyway, so can't do much about that. Anyway, we will be basically pulling it out today again and putting in another used, good condition XR6 turbo ZF box. This one's actually out of an FG, so we're going to just change the PCM or TCM or whatever you want to call it, the transmission controller, out of the box. We're going to change that over and the pan and stuff, and put the original converter back in. I'm going to keep that pink converter for the Valiant project, so we'll go from there. But yeah, new box, don't know if you can tell, but yeah, it is a turbo box and it is out of an FG, so still got the original converter in there. It's a non-milkshaked box, and yes, I did go and buy another one as well, so I do have another one. This one's out of a BF XR6 turbo, and it's going to be basically the box for the Valiant that I'm going to get built. So without further ado, we are going to lift this thing up in the air. Yes, it is really dirty. We've just finished having floods and I've driven through mud and water and everything in this, so I'm gonna put it up and drop the box out of it and go from there. The box has to come out. It's pretty simple with these, actually. Basically take the battery off, disconnect it. On this side, just there, two bolts on the starter motor. You can just let it hang. Drop those two pipes off, or you take that 10 mil out and pull the pipes out of there. You pop the clip there and so on for this selector, pop it off. Then you've got your connector there, which you have to do once you pull the pan off. You've got tail shaft. So both ends of the tail shaft and the center has to be undone. Then you've got, obviously, unbolt it there and at the diff. Do that. Then you've got six or seven bell housing bolts, which are pretty easy to get to. Then obviously, you pop this little cover off. You get in, you undo your torque converter bolts, and then you undo your two gearbox bolts on either side. Drop the cross member. Obviously, by that point, you've got the gearbox cross the gearbox jack underneath, and voila, straight out on the ground. We'll transfer across the computer. Yeah, basically just go from there with it. So yeah, change the computer across, new filter in that one, and then some new oil, and we'll put it back in. Hope for the best. Should be all right. Come with warranty, that's a good thing. And we're also going to fit a external oil cooler to the transmission, so that should be fun as well. All right, so box is out. New one is pretty much almost ready to go in. Just going to pop that off and I'll slip it up, and then I'll change the mechatronics, or drop the mechatronics unit, change the transmission computer in the actual car. That's probably the easiest way to do it that way. But yeah, so we'll just throw this box off on the ground, and a little pink converter. we'll do that and then throw the other box back up and start putting all back together.
All right, so it's been a minute. We have changed boxes, we have changed converters, a couple other little bits and pieces. We have put the new box in. I have changed the computer, I'll show you.
So I've changed the actual computer module on the mechatronics unit. So it's all done. As you can see inside the box, nice and clean, which is good. My other one that was in this was a little tainted, I'll show you. So I don't know if you can notice, but it's just that little bit not right. It's just a little bit slightly discolored. I think it was probably from when it was milkshaked. So the actual mechatronics unit that was in this one though, previously in that other box there, it was a little bit damaged, rusty or corroded or whatever you want to call it. So no, I'll throw this other one back in and then keep going. We have also decided to do a couple other things while we're here. While we have the front apart, we're doing a front mount intercooler. We're doing valve springs. We're doing 650cc or 60lb, 60 pound, whatever you want to call them, injectors. And we're going to go and get it tuned. So we're going to hit that 400 horsepower mark that we were aiming for. It's going to change from that in a minute. And also we've got to put in the PWR remote transmission cooler kit, which I have mounted the fittings already up here. I don't know if you can see. But yeah, so no, we'll keep going and hopefully finish it and then go and take it and get it tuned next week or the week after and make some power. All right, so box is all back in. Lines are all done. So I'm gonna leave it here for now and I'll be back next episode with a lot more stuff. So hang around, watch the next episode because it's gonna be fun filled with lots of new parts. So that will look a little bit different. Anyway, thanks again guys. Like and subscribe and I'll see you next time. Bye.
All the same, but some things never change. I couldn't stop and say no.